So the difference of squares is very like the difference of cubes, where we had a to the third minus b to the third. In this case, we just have a square, though. A squared minus b squared. We factor that into a minus b times a plus b. So this is going to be added to the third equation that we need to memorize for this coming up test here. Right, so let's go ahead and look at a short example here. What if we have x squared minus 16? Well, x squared minus 16 is a perfect square. We have to recognize that. I'm not going to, on the test, I wouldn't say it's a perfect square. We have to be able to look at it. Well, I see x squared. That should be a good indicator. And 16 is 4 squared. So when I see that, I notice that, oh, that's a perfect square. It has a 4 squared and has an x squared. So those are going to just be my A's and my B's. My A is going to be X, my B is going to be 4, and I just plug in the formula and I'm done. Add the X minus 4 times X plus 4. That is the end of the problem. So they're actually pretty short problems, just like the sum and difference of cubes factoring was. Okay, all right, let's look at another one here. See if I have 4x squared minus 25. Now here, I also want to recognize this is also a difference of squares. It's 2x squared and negative 5 squared, or just 5 squared. So 2x is going to be my A. I'm going to put that right there and right there. And 5 is going to be my B, and I'll put that right there and right there. And I'm going to do that. And I get my final answer there, 2x minus 5 and 2x plus 5. Now we also have problems that are going to have common factors first. So let's go ahead and look at two of those here. So for number one and two, 18 is not a perfect square. No number times itself is 18. That's just a integer. So what I need to do here is recognize that I am factoring, but I notice that they have something in common, 18 and 32. See who can raise their hand and give me first points there. What do they have in common, DeAndrew? Two, is that the largest one they have in common? What is, Ryan? Yeah, what is it?
Nine.
Do they both have a nine? 32 and have a nine? No? Adriana? Six. 32 doesn't have a six. No? No, Andrew's good. The two is correct. So all we can divide out is by a two. Okay. So I go ahead and divide each of those by two. And I bring that to the front. Okay. So I divide those by 2. I get 18 divided by 2. I get 9. D squared. Minus 16. Okay. Now the two is pretty much done. Once we factor it out, we don't do anything with the 2 anymore. We just leave it in front. Don't forget about it either. Leave it in front, though. Now, this 9p squared minus 16 is like the two problems we just did. It's a difference of squares. 9's a perfect square. 3 times 3. 16 is 4 times 4. So I got to notice here that if I have 9p squared, then A must be 3P. And if I have 16, then B is 4. And I'm just going to go ahead and plug that in my formula right here on the left of the whiteboard there. So I go ahead and plug that in. 3P, that's A, minus B is 4. A again, 3P. And this time plus B, which is 4. Okay, and then that'll be a final answer right there. Completely factored. We factor out a common term or a common multiple and then factored the leftover. Look at number two here. We want to do the same thing there. Factor out a common term. Okay. Okay. We first check if they both have a 16 in common. So I'll check that over kind of on the scratch work over here. Does it have both a 16? 16 into 19 once. 16 doesn't go into 32, so no, that's a no. Okay. Then the next one would be 8. But 8 wouldn't even give me a common. Wouldn't give me 2 left over, which isn't a perfect square, so 8's not a good example. So then 4, so probably would have to be 4. So you're going 4 into 196. 4 and 19, I get 4. 36, I get 9, so I get 49. And 49 is a good number to use here because that's a perfect square. So I'm going to go ahead and divide these both by 4. So that's what their largest common factor is there. And I divide them by 4. 16 divided by 4, I get 4k squared. Minus, and then we did that over here, we get 49. Okay. Then I want to go ahead and separate this into my A's and B's. I'm going to gonna go ahead and just write my parentheses out to fill in. So 4k squared, well, that's 2k. So 2k and 2k. And 49 is 7 squared, so minus 7 and plus 7. And I'll have my answer there.